5 of the Dorking career mode, and in last episode we saw 32 of our away fans getting a 3-0 win against Barnstable in the FA Trophy, second round. This episode we got Concord next. Find out who we've got in the third round of the FA Trophy. Maidstone, Tonbridge, I don't know how to pronounce that. Then we got the next few months fixtures on the screen there. So let's get back into it. I don't know when the draw for the second round is, but third round, sorry. I'm really bad this morning, but hey, here we go. Let's just get through these loading screens. It's a bit early today. It's 8 minutes past 8, hence why I'm a little bit tired and quiet. So we got the decrease in transfer revenue to 15%, which isn't really a concern. I'm not worried, I'm not selling anyone at the moment. We got the scout report from Concord, a team in Essex, I believe. Question about the squad's marker. So we can always hit them on the attack. The FA Trophy third round draws 64 teams in this one, so you got a few non-league teams, a few league teams, a few ones that I won't mind taking on. Preferably a non-league team in this round for us, hopefully gets us through, and we are. We're playing VCD, which stands for what exactly? They're a London team. They've got manager, but no their defender is their manager. He's played 12 games with one assist. He's 38. That's always helpful, a 38-year-old. Further than that, they got no one, so it should be a cruise in the next round. We just skip ahead to the next part. Concord's on the 12th. So our injury update, Jimmy's out. Teddy Ralph's out and Kane Wills is out. We've got Davies in the team of the week. That's not... No. I don't know who I thought that was then. Isaac Philpott. Why does his name not seem... How many games has he played? Because this guy does not sound familiar. He's been at the club a while. What? He's on a non-contract. He's a left winger. Why is he not on a contract? Right. We'll do that. We've got to give him some kind of contract, eh? 2 years. Let's just say 117 per week. He's happy with that. So we might have to put him in the first team. Yeah, he looked like he's a reserve player. That's not good. Just offering a contract to a reserve player that I never thought about. Always fun and games when you're looking for squad. He's a left back. Why he's not been in the team, I don't know. I should pay more attention to that, really. Having me what could be a backup left back on the squad would be a helping hand, I guess. So Kidderminster won in the FA Cup. That's not a bad game for them. and Colchester, who knocked us out, have gone through on extra time. It's all seeming to work out, really. We're still early on in the season. I think we need a few more wins to really establish where we're going to attack from on the table. I mean, we're third at the moment, Concord are 20th. We should, in theory, be an easy game for us, but there is no easy games in football. Anything can happen, as we know. The loading times, it does take a while, but that's probably because I got all five leagues that I could have on. Right, so he's... Philpott has signed a 2-year deal. That should then, I don't know why I've gone through this one, give us... No, he's a right back. Well, he could play left back though, can't he? Yeah, he can play left back as well, so it gives us the option to have an extra player on there. Sorry about that, just a bit of a yawn. So early on, we've got a defensive midfield who has the potential to go far. We have a good English defensive midfield from Dorking, so he was at the defensive midfielder. So can we view the youth candidates yet? No. Hopefully. The homegrown player can join us. I'll be certainly making that my aim for the... Oh, our game's been postponed. That's not good. Why has it been postponed? Is it... Oh, that means I got two games in hand. Did it give me a reason to why? Today's game due to a waterlogged pitch, so it's now going to be the Tuesday the 22nd. So that means our next game's VCD then. Okay, so it's not really affected us too much, I don't think. We just got an extra week off this week. Typical waterlogged pitch. It is genuinely realistic, this version of the game, with waterlogged pitch. So hopefully that gives us more of a chance of getting through the next round of the FA Trophy. With any luck, just save the game. As I drop my phone, I'm really not good at this whole let's be a streamer type thing, am I? So we got people making transfer options. I've got no budget for that. So my squad will pretty much be staying the same. Right, so the Dartford one, it puts me in a awkward position. It just means I got some games in hand. I know very little about VCD, right, so hopefully that suggests we should be able to go through to the next round of the FA Trophy. It'd be nice to see how far we get in that. I'm hoping to have key players back, but I'm not sure Jimmy will be fit enough for the game if not back in training. A Philpott, he might come in for his debut after signing a new contract, but I'm not too sure I want to risk having Kennedy out on the bench. It's always a risk when you play a different squad So we got the game on the Saturday, the draw for the fourth round will be on the Monday. Hopefully we can put our name into that one. Concord have just signed another player, that doesn't bode well for our Tuesday game. I'm looking at a win on this game, maximum points in next. He's capable of playing, is Jimmy, but I don't know if I want to risk it. The squad's not really going to change as much, really. So we're going to have the backup keeper in goal is normal. Rutherford, he scored the good goals in the last game. Briggs is coming in on the right. And then it's a case of McManus on the left, as he normally is. Jimmy, he needs a fitness test, really. Kane Wills is out. Phil Pott, he needs... Oh, everything's froze on me again. So, Phil Potts, he needs a bit of a fitness test, so he's not coming in as we're back. So does the other right back, so it's going to have to be our favourite pair of Fuller on the right and Kennedy on the left. In the middle we're going to go Sam, I'm just going to call him Sammy, I don't really want to get that name wrong. Ed Harris is coming in as well. And then I think we give more an option to play an attack every. For the last bit. For the last bits, we're just going to pick and pick positions. Seppi Sol, he's on a yellow card, I believe, and contract is running out. He don't actually have a contract, and he's just happy to be here for no money, apparently. Always an interesting one, but... Hey, whatever floats your boat, mate. We're 13 minutes in and we're about to play our first game of this episode. Hopefully we can get the points. It'd be nice to get through to the next round of the FA Trophy. It's a big cup competition in this level of football, as we are the home side as well, so it'll always be good to get a home win. Take away that. We've had one shot so far in the first 10 minutes, here's the first highlight. Playing it out from the back by the looks of it. Rutherford to McManus. Good pass there. What can he do? Is he going to go there? No, it's not. Oh, beautiful ball there. Can he get across? Can he? Oh, so close. It could have been 1-0. Could have been 1-0 in the first 12 minutes. There's the second highlight. Looks like we're on the attack again. And it's over. A dominant performance. Three shots in the first 15 minutes is always encouraging. Looks like we're hoping to get on the end of this one. Should be Kennedy's ball. Just start the breakaway. The crowd went up to... Oh, off the bar. He should have. He should have come down. He's a bit of a crowd. He's not going to do something. He just cut down off the wall. He should be 1-0 that, really. The players will look happy. We're going to fire him up a bit. Fire up the old entire team as we start from the back again. Quite a good idea, everyone. Will he pass or will he go for all his moves? Rigsaw. We're not exactly getting closer, we're getting the shots off, but we're not really getting closer. Maybe we can get on the end of that, yeah, there we go. One of our mainstays with a brilliant ball, and it's one again. On the left, the winger, Neil McManus, who scored his head this season, and the winger left over. Their keeper's quite good at giving the ball away, but that headed from anyone, they could come on the attack now. It's Bruce. We need to win this back now. It'd be nice if we could win it, but they're playing some good possession football at the moment. Most of all, that was their hands on that ball. We missed out the counter. And if he's got them on the right. So they'd this penalty. Kennedy's going to take it by the left of it. Come on, Kennedy, make it 2. Yeah, decent penalty. The team are left within 35 minutes. I think this might be cancelled. I don't know. They got in the way more. Can you send Rutherford on the attack or you go then? Go on, more. Briggs should be free. Yes, it is. Matthew Briggs, second of the season. Good through ball there by Moore. I did have a feeling he was going to go with only another shot, but he played the good pass from Briggs to him. Surely, he can't have stopped him. Come up to half time now, I'm going to praise the boys. Praise them. Matty Briggs is getting skinned apparently too much. I don't know on that one, he's going to stay on for a bit longer. We don't need to make any unnecessary subs. It'd be nice to give some of the boys a game off. I think if we get the next goal, it's complete game, set and match. You can't see him coming back. We're still going on the attack, which is always a good thing. It'd be nice to get another highlight this half, though. Been relatively quiet so far. Who's looking? See, the boys are looking alright. Gallagher might come off though. After this highlight. We could go on a counter and score a fourth, you never know. That was our keeper. I did take the play out the back thing off of our tactics, but they tend to do it anyway. Briggs down the right, he's got past one, gave it away, won it back though. More to Rutherford. He played it across the mountains. Gave it away now. Here they come. They can come on the break with Abbott. They seem to like passing it back, but they're into the box now and it's 3-1. William Beck. I've got to say that was kind of Kennedy's fault. We're going to make that change now. Gallagher's going to come off. And we're going to bring on McShane instead. And other than that, I don't think we need to make another sub, really. They've got a corner now. This, yeah, they've got a corner. Yeah. Oh, that's going down. We're going to allow the team to focus after conceding. Hopefully we can keep the win. It'd be nice to go through to the next round of the FA Trophy. I think we're definitely going to be in the next round, Hat. Manus is looking tired, but there's the game over. Briggs got a 7.8. He was not our man of the match. Kennedy was, by the looks of things. No, Harris. Make your mind up. Harris with an 8.2 was probably our best player rate in this game. As we go on to Concord, it might be a total different team when I play Concord, but you never know. People are happy. Who else has gone through? Evesham are out. Guys are out. Bradford Park Avenue's out. Concord drew, but then went out on penalties. That's always a good sign. They'll be a bit disappointed. Not a lot of non-league teams went through. That's a shame. Games are always better when they've got non-league underdogs in, I guess. We received 4.5k from that, which isn't bad. Harris is on form. Yeah, Harris got the man of the match for us. We're in the hat for the Monday draw. And then we're fourth now, even though we didn't play last Saturday. We got Concord on the Tuesday, have one of our game in hand. If we can win our games in hand, we should end up being near the top of the table. I think we've got two on compared to the rest of them in our league. It has to save again, don't it? Loading times on the saving aren't the best. Going in, looking at the results. It'd be nice to get someone in our own league in the next round. Or maybe a league above, but we know pretty much all the teams in our league, so... Maidstone's on 13 games, we're on 11, so we got one game in hand against the most of them, and then the two games in hand in against the minority of the teams in our league. We're doing alright though so far, I have to say. Get another game in. We're away against Concord, so I reckon an easy a draw at the least is what we're expecting. They are considered a poor team compared to the quality that we have, so we should be the favourites in that one. We're going to watch the draw. 32 teams in this round. I would just click draw next team, but by the time you get to the bottom of the thing, just messes up. Looking at it, they're all league teams, I reckon. Oh no, we got Cray Valley. They're a non-league team, they're the only one left in it. So we get Halifax from the FC Halifax from the league above, which there isn't really much of a gap. So the only non-league team left in it has Weymouth at home. Who else have we got? Boreham Wood, they're always a strong one. They're at home to Torquay. Blythe are always a cup upset. They're away to Hereford. Other than that, Notts County in the National League are playing away at Chester. They should go through easily. But you never know in cup football, and we got another rearranged game. The rearranged games will end up having some effect on the team, I have no doubt. Not having the money to get any extras in. Some of our strikers, Sol in particular, deciding to play for free. Injury update. I just don't know. Recently returned from injury. He's probably needing a fitness test. No, fitness test remain not required. Isaac Philpott's passed his, so he might get a game to give Kennedy one off. So we'll go with Sam Howes back in goal, being our first choice keeper. He's still saying he needs a fitness test. No, he's passed it, sorry, but they reckon he can only do 45 minutes, which isn't good. Ben Dyer is coming in. Kane Wills is back in the squad. James McShane, he can go in centre attacking. And then we got Jason Pryor, 7-goal hero so far. He's coming in. I want Sol on the bench, but it's a bit of a risk if you ask me personally. We're going to unpick Picks, and Alfie Rutherford, with 3 goals in 6 games, is on the bench. Briggs is on the bench, and then you got Harris, and I'm going to put Wheeler on the bench as well. Jimmy's not going to play. Briggs is coming in and Moore's going to be on the bench. I don't really want to risk Jimmy. He's still really short of fitness. And then we'll go from there. Hopefully we can pick up a easy win away at Concord. Concord are a team based in Essex, I believe. Let me just make sure I'm in the right frame of mind with that one. When Google wants to load up. So according to Wikipedia, Concord Rangers, they're called, are based in Canary Island in Essex, so I was right at least for one thing, which is always a good thing. So we're getting to the games then. We're at Thames Road according to Wikipedia. I don't know what stadium they have in game though. So we'll go with that. We're away team, so a draw wouldn't be so bad, but we've basically come in to look for the win. And we got a highlight here, Fuller on the right, one of the mainstays in the team when he's fit. Pryor plays it back to Davies. McManus on the left, he scored in the last game. He's got Kennedy overlapping, but he's going his own way back in the squad. Fuller on the right, what's he going to do? Sends it across, and it's saved. But they can't get it clear. Kennedy, oh, he's over. He's just over that one. Sure. Oh, they've got this here. Saved by the keeper, though. They got through behind us quite easily on that one, though. They didn't count that as a shot for them, though. That's weird. We've had 2 shots, 1 on target so far. We got a corner here, though. Comes in on your head, son. Cleared out. They're going to hit on the counter now. Their fans are egging them on. Are they going to do it? They've finished. No, we've intercepted, but there's no one down there. Players chasing, but I think their defence is going to clear this easily back to our keeper. He boots it up and, oh, what a head by Davies. Shane, McShane's through now. Briggs, oh, that's a goal, Matthew Briggs. Third of the season, he scored in the last game as well. He's got a bit lucky with the way the ball fell, and then Davies made that with his brilliant head, and McShane's pass worked as well. Shot turned pass after the rebound. But Matthew Briggs in for a clear shot on goal. And he don't miss that man. Yeah. We came for a win and we're leading. It's not been a bad first half away from home. Still time to increase that lead though. They've not had a single shot apparently, according to this. I think they had one highlight though. And what we're going to do is we're going to praise the team now. Are we able to praise? There we go. Praise the whole entire team for a brilliant first half performance. They've come back and started the second half well. They've had two shots. None on target though. We're sat with 8 at the moment. We're going to fire them up a bit. We're encouraging them now. Wheeler can come on for Briggs. Give Briggs a rest. We go. They've got a corner here. Can we get it clear? Here's Saver. Lucky for us, we should have got it cleared. How's Future Lip? I think he's giving that away. Yeah. They can come back at us here. For sure. Back to the keeper. Kennedy was there that time, but no one was quite reading Kennedy getting ahead of that. I think they might have us on the break here. Davies missed it. And it's going to be wide. How we missed that, I do not know. That was a brilliant chance for them to come in and take the equalising goal. What we're going to do is we're going to tell the team to focus and we're going to have a look at who we can bring on. More can come in for Wales. And to shore up the defence a bit, we're going to bring in Harris. And that's our subs for this game. Hopefully that can help us a bit. There's 4 minutes left. I think we won this comfortably. 11 shots, 5 from target. They had their chances though. They had the one in the first half where they could have gone 1-0 up, but he passed it into the keeper's hands, and then they had the one where it was an open goal really, and they popped it over. So it weren't as comfortable as the stats show, but we'll take the win. That puts us to 25 points, one below the league leader, but we've got a game of hand against Ebbsfleet. Davies shines, even though he had the chance to intercept the ball that went over the top, he still shined in the game. We're away at Maidstone next. That's a top of the table clash, kind of. We're third, they're fourth. And we still got a game in hand against Maidstone, so even if they do beat us or we don't particularly get the right result, then we still have the chance to overtake them. It'd be nice to get the win, but we might have to play a depleted side because we got Maidstone on the Saturday and then Tonbridge or Torn, I don't know, but we play them on the Monday, so back to back games really, one day of rest. This might be the game where Kennedy and Fuller might play my strong squad for this one and then my weaker squad for the other game. I think we're going to need our strongest for the Maidstone game. I didn't realise how quick that Monday game came around really. It's a bit unfair, but it's what you get for having waterlogged pitches, I guess. A fitness test is not required, does that mean he's back? Let's have a look. We'll just quick pick this one. He's on the bench, which isn't bad. Briggs is starting. We don't need two defenders on the bench. We're going to give that to Alfie Redford. We're hoping to get the 3 points in this one as well. Make it six out of the last two league games. We're playing good football at the moment. The fans are enjoying it. They're liking the formation. I've turned into the tactical requirement. Tuned in. I don't know. Briggs starting is not good, but yeah, he scored two goals in the last two games, so you never know. They've got a free kick here straight away. This is in a dangerous position. He sent it across and it's 1-0. Leading United with two goals. Good passion, really. It was a good goal coming into the right area. I think they didn't win. We're having Short, two on target out of there, so he's not had a highlight yet though. He's just hoping we can get a highlight. We're going to fire him up a bit. We need a bit of open hand, let's fire him up. We're not a bit quiet on our end this half. Three shots to one target, no highlight for us. We can't go a whole half without a highlight, surely. I think we will do though. Something needs to give in the second half. We're gonna demand more from the whole entire team, and we're gonna sorry about that. We're gonna go very attacking in the second half, see if we can get back into it. It'd be nice to have a way back in, but I think they're gonna make it harder for us here. They've got all number of interceptions. Can we go on the attack? Why is David away? Come back, they've got us, they're over the top, they're into the box, they're 1-on-1. Got Rendell, into it too. It was inevitable. Due to the air, but that was going to happen. Hopefully we can try and get back into it. The net goal is really important. Our players are kind of there. Need to intercept, oh they're through again, it's safe in the hole. Should have been a three really. We're just letting him in, that's the problem we're going with attacking. Harris is just doing that over the problem anyway, so coming back in the fully point. Gargan, active for the Moore's now found himself on the right. Moving the ball now nicely. He gave it away, but Rose will pick it up. He boots it. Briggs can keep it in. Just about. Fellas now got the chance to cross. Goes to Gallagher. The Wells, the shot from distance is just about 15 minutes gone. We've still got time to come back into it. We've got a throw in here. We're going to fire him. Dorking's in across and trying to get back into it, but I think two's just too high of a scoreline to close down. We've got McShane gonna come on. I'm gonna put him in for Gallagher and then move these two around. Jimmy's going to come in for his first start after injury. Hopefully these two can have a positive impact. Send it across and it could go, but I just have a bad feeling about this one. We might have lost it. McManus is looking dead. Kennedy with a corner. Comes to send it back in. Fire at McManus. And it's out of the finish. 15 minutes to go. McManus has scored a 4-4 if they scored in the last one. And we've got back in for another corner here. Kennedy. Missed everyone. Can we go on the attack now? McShane's got to get around. He's into the box with a shot. You just had a feeling that that could have gone either way then. We're going to bring Pryor off for Riddersford. And see if that's positive. A 2-1 loss is better on paper than 2-0, but we want to try and equalise here. We've got McManus and sends it in. Where is the striking from Super Bowl? That was an absolute miss. They could put a game beyond or down now if they get in beyond us. So we need to clear his passage to the keeper. Harris just gave it away. Harris has no reason to do that. Coming back out, referee, should be game set match, what a save that is. That save has kept us in it for now. But we've just been second best all game really. We need to get it clear, not clear enough. Just as well there, by the way, can we put the pressure on there? If we're going to nick a draw, we need to do it soon. I think it might just be out of the realm of the possibility. They've got 4 minutes left of that injury time. I think that's it and we've lost. No, they free kick here. That was a great save, but it's just delaying the inevitable. Unless we can clear this encounter. It'd be cruel on Maid and Head United though. You deserve a win after how they played. We might come away with a counter attack now. No one's crossing their goat to get in the middle of the corner. Kennedy's to take the throw. McShane brings it in, headed out, and it's cleared. Nice to keep it alive. It might just be a bit too much now. Fuller sends it back here and it's over. It's a deserved win for Maiden. Maidstone United. I don't know why I just called him in the last 2 seconds of the video. I'm really not good at this, am I? It's unfortunately we lost, but we got the Monday game to try and get us back somewhere into it. We're going to play a different squad lineup for the next game. We're going to just do a pick rotated squad, see what the game comes up with and go from there. It'd be nice to give Kennedy and Fuller a game off, but I don't know if we can afford it realistically after that loss. We shall see. Saving the game. I think this one's going to be a bit longer episode than normal parts. Ideally I want to play a couple more games just to get the season past December. Saying that, this is the next game. Then we got Hampstead, Braintree, St Albans. We'll play to the FC Halifax game. And we'll see if we can get through to the FA Trophy. This Monday game It's come way too early, really, for us. But it gives us the best chance to get over the disappointment. No training ground scuffles before this game. They probably had a day off, a rest day, coming to it. We are meant to be favourites, but I don't know if my squad will manage to live up to that expectation. We're going to pit rotate his squad, and we come up with... We're not going to do that. We're going to have Teddy Ralph on the right, Barry Fuller's having a day off, Isaac Philpott on the left. Neil McManus, sub 5. We're not doing that at all. Jimmy is not being our striker. It's just not happening. We can change it so it's like that, I guess. And then McShane can come in for a game. But we'll change more McShane and we'll go from there. Hopefully, it'd be nice to see if we can get a win. Some of the players are not looking too happy. They could get us on the wings on the counter. With any luck, we won't. We need to show a dominant side. People aren't happy, but it's what has to be done. The fans might not like the certain players starting, but here we go. So with our free kick first highlight, things are across the field. And this is the counter I've heard about. Can we stop him? He's passed it back, so it's not really a threatening candle to his keeper. Boots it up. We're penning him back though. Can only pass it back. Can we get an interception? Whether we can. But the header just doesn't go anywhere. Comes back at us, there three now. Williams is behind. And the shot goes wide. Let's see. Can we get a hold of this game? A highlight for us would be nice. We're gonna tell the team to focus. Get it clear. No, we can't. Can we either keep it in? Just about, but he's got nowhere to go. This passing about does scare me a bit, and it just boots it up for no particular reason. We could have found a different pass, surely. They seem to have guys everywhere, and they're just struggling to get hold of the ball at the moment by the looks of it. We string a few passes here and there. Taylor. Ralph on the right, coming in for Fuller. So, he should be us. Striker, or he's meant to be striker. McShane, oh, cinches, right. That could have been it, that could have gave us a foothold in this game. I think we need to fire him up, really. They're just not listening. No, we're not able to. Well, Jimmy back from injury, can't do nothing. Ralph needs to squeeze it across and straight into the keeper's hands. It's not been the best first half for us. We're going to pick that up easily. Beautiful up there, no one's there though. Our long balls have just not worked this half. Taylor with the interception there. Moore's got no one to really pass it to. Jimmy on the right, he's going to go for a run. His shot from distance was just a pointless shot, really. He did not need to do that. We've got the more shots, but it just seems like a flat Monday after the Saturday game. We might have to switch up and go very attacking in the second half. they're playing it as roundabout. We've intercepted that, but our strikers come way too deep, and when we intercept, he missed that, and that was shocking. I don't know what to say with our defence, has let us down. It's not great. His header just wasn't anywhere near the ball. He deserved to be 1-0 down for that. We're going to fire him up. That was shocking. Can we equalise with that? We've got Ralph on the right. Chengo's from distance, and it's depressing to watch him. Yep, just had to change the battery pack of my controller. So as I was saying, we're going very attacking for the second half. We need to get back into it. We deserve to be 1-0 down, really. We've been playing some shocking football, really. It's going to go bad for the moment. Unfortunately, he's coming on for Jimmy. It's not much better in terms of fitness. More for Gallagher, we're doing that. We'll go with what they say. We've moved up to second with that, but made saying I've played 15 games. Absolutely played 15 and they've just set the lead. This is their 15th century. We're still on 14. We've still got a game of hand. And thanks to Giuseppe Sol, we've managed to turn this game completely around in the space of a half. Giuseppe Sol. He's not the best striker, but compared to prior, getting 2 goals in 1 game, I'm happy with his performance there. 2 corners, 2 headers. Always good when that happens. He's 32. Jury's still out. 20 games in. Should you see how I'm doing? 20 games in. I've won 65% of the game. It's not bad. One player brought, one player sold. Who did I sell? I do not know my history. Player brought for 20k. Was he 20k? He was, yeah. I knew that. He put us into debt. Jason Price, our top scorer. And then Hanstead's the next game in 5 days, so at least we get a little break now. be good to come back and get another win. We are away. Some of these away games are just coming out of nowhere, really. Messi has 6 months left on his contract. This ain't good. Negotiate. This ain't good. We're gonna have to find a way of dealing with this. Everyone of my core players seem to need a new contract. We'd be struggling next season if none of these can get into it. I think it is practically the whole team as well. We're going to have to work miracles here. None of them really want to. Fuller, he's 36, he's probably retiring. Briggs, 24, doesn't want to. Wheeler, 30. We're going to struggle next season, that's for sure. Not looking like a good decision now to buy Aaron Davies, to be fair. We're going to be so far over the wage bill, it's going to be unreal. And there's how the other half live. Triggered it. We go with that. He can trigger the contract. Our reserves are not looking too great either. They're sitting without a win out of 12 games. We've lost them all pretty much by more than one goal each game. We're not great. We're not great on the reserve side of things. Coming up to 60 minutes. There's a few games I want to get through. We're going to go up to the FC Halifax game. See if we can break away into it. Messi wins Footballer of the Year. That's always happening. Always happening. Be interesting to see who wins it when Messi's not around. Hamel Hampstead, they're 11th in the league. We're 3rd. And I think we've still got a game in hand. We might be able to nick it. Oh dear. Birmingham are out with Colin. Talking about my beloved team. They're not doing too bad in the game. Better than real life, I guess. We're going to quick pick this. Get our regulars back in. Aaron Davies, Kennedy, Fuller. This is going to be a bit controversial, but I'm going to put Pryor on the bench and see if we can build off Giuseppe Sol's brilliant last game. We're not having two defenders on the bench, it's just not happening. But we'll put Jimmy on the bench. We've lost 12k last month. Not looking good. We need something to happen. Moore is now able to perform well in his new position. I didn't even know he was going for a new position. But hey, there we go. Hamel Hampstead. Kitty Minster are the top goal scorers in the FA Cup. Nice. Ooh, there's been some breaking news here. In the world of football. Jeez, so. That means someone in Germany is without a manager. Shall we have a look? Let's have a look at the job centre, why not? Who's got no manager? Quite a lot of Portuguese sides and Spanish sides. Halifax are without a manager, that might bode well for us in the FA Trophy. And then you're looking down, you've got Grimsby League 2, Port Vale League 2, Oxford 1, Blackpool without a manager. Blackpool have struggled very badly in recent years. Oh, apparently they do have a manager. What are they looking for there? I do not know. Unless it's caretaker manager. Are you caretaker manager? Yeah, I think he is. Let's have a look at his history. Hired as caretaker manager of Blackpool, yeah. Who have they got? They haven't really got much of a squad, have they really, Blackpool? They got Ben Woodburn. From Liverpool. His contract ends on the 17th. Does that mean no, I don't think that means we can have him on free. It might just be his loan comes out. He wouldn't move that low down in the leagues anyway. It's a Hamel and Hampstead away game. Hopefully we'll pick up a nice away win to take into the next games. Barcelona's Dembele signs a new 3-year deal. That's always good. So yeah, we got still got a game in hand. This is not. Is this gonna be my starting? We go with it. We're happy with that. Giuseppe Sol is lacking sharpness, but we don't care. Ooh, they're not happy with Will starting. Davies is great. This is what you call coaching, apparently. Let's go Dorking. Hopefully we can pick up a win. It'd be nice to get a shot off early. Our passing's 84%, so it shows that we can pass the ball. We've got 62 possession. We've had 7 corners, but here's a highlight now. Played Kennedy with the ball. McManus back in the squad. Sends it across the bridge. Gallagher now gives it away. And they've both put me into that for the defenders of the state. And their cross is not perfect. When it goes, I'm not sure. I'm not the perfect spot when I'm looking for them. I guess I'm not the perfect spot. Can we get back into it? We're firing up a bit. We need to kind of grab the game now. We've not had a highlight ourselves yet this half. It might be the second game that we go for a whole half without a highlight. We've had poor shots on target. And we're going to have to go very attacking in the second half. See if we can open them up. It's not looking good so far. It might just be the amount of games we've played. We've had 5 shots now, 2 on target. I'm gonna demand more from the whole team. if we can get our heads to any of it. We've got a highlight here. For this throw, just given away. Gonna see who's on the bench. We're gonna bring Pryor McShane on. McShane for more. Being our first. If that makes any sense. Hopefully it will. If needs to be, it'd be Sol coming off, but Kennedy's injured now. Philpott's gonna come in for his first game of the first team. It's not good having Kennedy out, he's one of our mainstays. It's 10 minutes in now, hopefully we can nick it. One last highlight will do for us, but I think we might be out of time. 88, 89, 5 minutes extra time. Can we nick it here, Harris? Harris is a good second for us, though. Unfortunately, we didn't really need the draw, but we still have the game in hand that we could potentially use to our advantage. But it's been a poor couple of games now from us. Most teams are on 16 or 15 games. Concord down the bottom of 14. Not looking great, and we've lost our starting left back for 6 weeks to 3 months, so that's probably the rest of the season it'd be out for, if not the majority. Hammer Hampstead away, they looked on paper like it should have been an easy win. We've got a home game against Braintree where we could get back to winning ways, hopefully. Saving game again, it saves quite a recent amount of time. I'm hoping Philpott can come up and maybe steady the ship a bit. We're not in a bad position, it'd just be nice to get another one. Manus has got a 1 year deal, Pryor's new deal, Kennedy new deal. All these new deals are good, but it's going to put us in to debt really. With any luck. And that's how the other world, they're buying or discussing a new contract for Coleman. Epsfeet are now the longest, the leading goal scorers in the FA Cup. It's just unreal. Inter have begun contract renews with one of their players, and we're just happy to get to Saturday where we can play Braintree. Intrigue, Braintree. Gallagher signs a new deal, so the core of our squad might stay the same, but we're gonna somehow struggle. We need some reinvestments. I don't think we're gonna get it. Ham and Hampstead have just won again, so they're on a good vein of form at the moment. We've just unlocked a clean bill of health, no injuries for 2 months. How does that work? Because I've just lost. I don't understand how I managed to get that achievement, really, because I've lost people for injury throughout. Yes. Not really great. So we're just letting everyone else have their game in hands, really, haven't we? Maidstone's just won again, so they're coming back up. We've still got a game in hand against them, and two against Debsfleet, who are runaway game leading now. Braintree are 16th, but I can't see it being an easy game for us. TNS are securing players left, right and centre here for their Welsh League. The Welsh League's an interesting one if you ask me personally. Okay, so Concord and Ham and Hampstead have been postponed again. Dorking against Braintree goes ahead. Kennedy's injured still. Squad, I'm gonna have to put Isaac in. Where is he? He's gonna have to come in for the injury. It's then going to be Josh Taylor on the bench. Sol for Pryor. Jimmy's coming in for Briggs. And then it's going to be Luke Moore on the left. Hopefully, we can try and get back to winning ways. With any luck. Yes, we're ready. And teams are warming up, everyone's getting ready. The fans aren't happy, but we've got to go with it. Go again, Gallagher. Fuller. He really is playing like a long this time. Considering the length of the game. He's playing it, isn't he? Thank you. Cross now. Can we get another highlight in the second half? Our fitness levels on the starting 11 are looking good. McManus and Jimmy on the right might have to come off. Dorking are playing some good football there at the moment. I'm going to do the early subs just to keep the players fresh. So we're going to bring McShane on. McShane on for Jimmy on the right, and then Giuseppe Sol for McManus, see if he can come in and get another goal. Comes across now, we've got another highlight here. I think this is down by our goal line area, they feel this ends it up in midfield. And that might just be the end of it there. Good position there, lost a game that was probably with two from the spot. You had more coming in the second of the game and McManus got the first, and then substitute James McShane has just ended it really for them. That fifth goal was wanted and warranted, but a bit harsh on the other team. And we've just got a reward for a thumping there. Where's that put us, really? We've gone top of the league by 1 point there. We've got a game in hand as well. We're in a comfortable position now. Who we got next? Let's have a look at our schedule. We've got St Albans next. St Albans City there. I don't actually know where they're based, so I might have to have a look on Wikipedia for that. Good old Wiki. I like to try and get some knowledge of where I'm next at. So according to them, they are based in Clarence Park. That's their stadium name. But yeah, I don't really know much about the team, really. Sponsored by rock band Enter Security, which is always interesting. I know that they've got to be from the south somewhere, but I really have no knowledge. So the FA Cup's looking tasty with Portsmouth still there. Portsmouth versus Coventry, that would be a good one. I don't know if anyone actually saw any of that. Ooh, Portsmouth won 2-0 with a Coventry sending off, and Everton went to penalties against Barnsley, who scored in the 89th minute. That would have been some drama there. Would have been some interesting drama. So the St Albans are 15th, and we are top of the league as it stands currently. They want Harris. Ed Harris. Is he part of a contract? I believe it ends on the end of the season. We're gonna have a look at this. It's not gonna happen. Ed Harris wants to stay, so Ed Harris will be staying. We're absolutely playing Birmingham in the FA Cup. Let's see how my favourite team's doing. Karanka's still on the chairs. They got Djukovic. How many games has he played? This guy's a superstar. He scored 4 goals. Okay. 4-13 is not good, but there we go. Clark, Salter, and Djukovic just scored. The mighty Birmingham City. If that job becomes available at any point in this career, I will take it. I will take it without a shadow of a doubt. Dickinson? James Dickinson. He must be part of the reserves. I'm not going for that. Dorking are favourites, and we had Gallagher, Fuller, McManamus, and Pryor in the team of the week. Always good. Where are we looking? We're 7:45 kickoff. Nice little Saturday night thing. So here's what we're gonna do. We are gonna bring Teddy Ralph in on the right. He seems a bit more of a happier player on the right. Fuller's coming in on the left. Aaron Davies coming in again. Ed Harris, who wants to stay at the club, is coming in. Now we got Kane Wells is a beast of a goal scorer. And he's going to play with Gallagher, yeah, he's going to have Gallagher there. On the right, it's really hard because they're all in good. I'm going to put Jimmy on the right. They're all in good form at the moment. McManamus on the left. Luke Moore or James McShane? It's going to be McShane after his goal. And Pryor's going to come in and hopefully get double figures. And then we're just going to quick pick the bench. We're not having two defenders on the bench though. We're going to have Luke Moore on the bench. And we're going to come away with a win, hopefully. This is our game before the FC Halifax game. Teddy Ralph is lacking match sharpness. I don't care, really. We've got a strong-ish side. We've got Kennedy still out injured, which I still don't understand how I managed to get the reward for non-injured players over 2 months. We're in red again. We're in red. We're our home kit away. Not a bad shout. I want us to remove. If I wanted to remove it, I would have removed it myself. We've had 5 shots on target. Here's a highlight now for you. We send it in and it's unfortunate. Goes down. How is that not a foul? I do not know. Shot from the distance, I think it's safe to go on the line. We'll change him at half time. Here they come now. That was a good tackle by Ralph. Should have been a foul, but they won it back. Played it quickly, though. Nice and good. Good breaking. Thank you. I guess I'm a bit of a hard time missing. It's not in need of any subs as such, but we're not going to take any chances. We're going to bring more in for Wales. More cover for the defence. We don't need any other cards, but we ain't. Haven't really got the ability to chance it and take on. Hopefully we can remain in the win. We're gonna fire the boys up a bit. And we're gonna change our mentality to a bit more attacking, just to see if we can do this. Fire's gotta have to. Now they've got to highlight feathers on the ball. More McShane. There we go. McShane's gonna go. He went alone and he went over. Hopefully we can. We're gonna do that, why not? We've took the points away with a Jason Pryor hat trick. Nice and easy as you do it. Going into the FA Trophy game now. We've got another achievement, a hat trick achievement. It's only took us 17 games to get it. Pryor on form. And going into the FC Halifax game, I don't know if Pryor's actually going to play the game though. Dorking in the game against Halifax. So we've basically coming up to the last game in this video. It's not been a bad video as such. We're going to do the FA Trophy and then we're going to do the draw and then we'll call it an end to this one. We've been streaming for about an hour and a half, near enough hour and 40 minutes. Be nice to get through to the fifth round of the FA Trophy. Pryor's probably going to have a rest. He's been scoring too many goals in the last few games. We're classed as the underdogs, which is always a good thing for this squad. Bouncing back, we're going to have Aaron Davies coming in. Backup keeper coming in. Giuseppe Sol, he's on a... Alfie's got more goals than Sol. But we'll give them both a go at it, I guess. McShane. He can come in. Attack mid. And then we're gonna picked positions. With looking strong, too many defenders on the bench again. That's going to change to Giuseppe Sol on the bench, why not? If I don't play Pryor, that would be a good move. We're looking strong with our 4-4-1-1. Be nice to get through to the next round of the cup. The fans are generally happy. We've got a chance of doing well. Yeah, the fans, I agree with the fans on that one. Coming through, we've had one shot so far. We've got a highlight here. Unfortunately, I didn't go in, but we started strongly against the team above us. They've got a free kick, they could send this deep into our box. Webber takes it from the Pushes it up, but no one's really there now. Well, he's got freaks on the side. Off the corner of the crossbar. So unlucky. That could have been the way into the lead we needed. A highlight here, hopefully we can get back into it. fella on the right. Breaks now. Sends it through machines into the box. This wide. It is a terrible angle. And back into the game, but it's actually not coming from where we need him to be. Halifax taking 2-1 lead into half time maybe. The highlight just before half time, it could make it all level. We're gonna fire him up a bit more. Fire him up a bit more, see if that can do anything. Try and get back into it. Gallagher's looking a bit tired, Davies is looking tired, we got a highlight here. Very attacking style we're playing. He's wide. Really has to be fighting. This thing can be cool sometimes. It's gonna be a sub. We're gonna bring Giuseppe Sold on from McManus on the left. And then we're going to change it, same exchange on the left. And Sol's in the middle. Hopefully that can give us some more attacking options. Uh, 70 minutes, and we need to do something now. 75 minutes, we're going to have to make another sub. We're going to bring Wheeler in on the right for Greg, for Briggs, and Pryor, the superstar, coming on. Hopefully we can make it 2-2 and take it to extra time or penalties. We've been known to be a penalty specialist in these cup games with our keeper. There's 10 minutes, yeah, I think we've bit more than we can chew. And we get a last minute, 3 minutes of extra time, I think we may have bit more. Here we go, we got a highlight. Could it be a last ditch? I think so. Needs to go in the box. That was Pryor. He's finally stepping gone and done it. And Pryor there. How could he be running down? For the season. I don't think Halifax was that expecting that to happen. So it's going to be an uneventful first half of extra time. We may be able to change change the way this game goes. We look like we were out and buried, but now we might be going to penalties. Have we got any way of making another serve? Is anyone remaining? I don't know. Philpott could come in maybe, if it lets me. I don't think it will. Harris can come off. We're going to change it. I don't know if it would let me. It did. We changed it a bit. I don't know. We've just got to hold on now. A few more minutes, maybe. Looking intense, this. Yeah, they're standing off and they seem to just be soaking up the pressure. It goes to penalties. It's going to be an interesting turn of events. We're just going to... He's going to pick the way I was going to pick, so we'll just do that. It's basically line for line. And we're going to continue. It's going to be penalties. It's going to be penalties. Jason Pryor to put us in the lead. Be a heartbreaking way to leave the FA Trophy. Come on, leave it. He's in. Unfortunately, I've just basically scored all their penalties perfectly. We do so well normally on penalties, and we just couldn't get through that one. We are out of the FA Trophy. The only thing we have to focus on now is the league. It's so unfortunate. It was such a good game that we either just missed it. We've received 1.5. I don't quite really know what to say. Pryor came on and gave us hope, but it just wasn't enough. Our next game's against Dartford and then Billericay. We're going to leave this episode here. And a heartbreak. Thanks for watching.